here are computational details. Again, here we use Gaussian O3 and this approach with BCRLib functional and 631G star basis set. This approach previously was shown to be very suitable for metalloporphyrin studies. And for every species, both singlets and triplets were studied. And solvent effects were estimated using this kind of approach implemented in Gaussian with water, benzene, and acetonitrile as solvents and with corresponding dielectric constants used. So, and now I would like to show you results of our studies, which answer the question, what happens when nitrogens in pyrroles are replaced with phosphorus. So here we have structure and frontier orbitals of nickel porphyrin. What is interesting about this molecule, that it's not flat, it's slightly distorted due to small size of nickel. So here is the angle this carbon nickel and this carbon. We can see that it's quite strongly smaller than 180 degrees. And we can see that HOMA and HOMA minus 1 have very small or no contributions from nickel, and LUMAS have smaller contributions from nickel, so mostly contributions are from the porphyrin ring, as expected. So what happens when we substitute this for pyrrole nitrogens with phosphorus? We obtain the species which has bowl-like shape, where this angle now is almost 20 degrees smaller than for the original nickel porphyrin. And as we can see, also frontier orbitals look quite different from the frontier orbitals of the original nickel porphyrin. What about charges in this system? So here are Mulliken charges in the original nickel porphyrin. As we can see, high positive charge on nickel and high negative charge on pyrrole nitrogens, which is expected. But situation in the phosphorus substituted porphyrin is completely different. Negative charge on the central nickel and positive charges on phosphorus atoms. So, and here are calculated binding energies of nickel for this porphyrin, both in gas phase and with solvent effects included. Of course, these estimations are quite crude, but they can tell us that these kind of compounds should be stable and can be synthesized. So, complete replacement of pyrrole nitrogens in the nickel porphyrin with phosphorus centers was found to produce the species nickel porphyrin phosphorus 4, which has unusual electronic and structural features, which are drastically different from the original nickel porphyrin, as we just have seen. Therefore, tetraphosphorus substituted nickel porphyrin can possess interesting novel properties, including reactivity, which could lead to its various potential applications. And potential high stability of this tetraphosphorus nickel porphyrin, both in the gas phase and different solvents, was shown, which implies feasibility of its synthesis. So here are noticeable features of metal tetraphosphorus porphyrin compounds, exemplified by nickel tetraphosphorus porphyrin, which would make them quite different from the parent metal porphyrin compounds. First of all, very strong geometry distortions, as we saw. Charge distribution opposite to that in metalloporphyrin species. Also, stabilization of the LUMA of tetraphosphorus substituted metalloporphyrin compared to the LUMA of metalloporphyrin. which causes noticeable closure of the homoluma gap and changes in redox properties of tetraphosphor-substituted metalloporphyrins compared to the original species. And also electron richness and possible polarizability of the tetraphosphorus-substituted metalloporphyrins compared to the original metalloporphyrins. All these features can lead to the potential applications in light harvesting systems or in disynthesized solar cells, similar to tetrapyrrole species, in catalysis, in donor-acceptor complexes with fullerenes, in two- and three-dimensional nanoclusters made of of this kind of species, so where they could be connected via covalent or non-covalent linkages. Again, with potential applications in catalysis, light harvesting, and photovoltaics. So currently, I'm doing study of two-dimensional clusters of two-dimensional nanoclusters of tetraphosphorus substituted nickel metalloporphyrins, but this research is still in process and has not been published yet. Okay, so this is so far everything about my research done at Duke University. So now I would like to tell something about my previous research done at Emory University, namely studies research on polyoxymetallase and water oxidation. I will start with computational studies of the geometry and electronic structures of tetra-ruthenium polyoxymetallate catalyst for water oxidation. So first of all, let's talk about motivation of this research. From 2008 till 2004, this complex was studied by the theoretical and experimental groups from Emory University. So as we can see, this complex is free of organic ligands, and it was shown to exhibit several reversible one-electron redox couples, oxidation-reduction, and it was also shown to catalyze both electro-oxidation and chemical oxidation of water in aqueous solution. So here is the structure of this compound. As we can see, there are two silicon tungsten 10 two silicon tungsten 10 ruthenium 2 monomeric units, which are rotated by 90 degrees around the C2 axis, going in this direction, and the total symmetry of the total symmetry of the molecule is D2D. In this core, ruthenium 4, mu oxygen 4, mu OH2. H2O 4 with the charge 6+. Four ruthenium centers make a slightly distorted tetrahedron with ruthenium distances ranging from 3.5 to 3.7 angstroms, so relatively close to each other. So the polytungstate ligands gamma silicon tungsten 10 O36 of this polyoxymetallate stabilize the ruthenium 406 core over several oxidation states possible, these oxidation states are needed for catalytic water oxidation, and it's known that these ligands are themselves oxidatively hydrolytically and thermally stable. At the same time, salts of this polyoxymetallate are molecular and soluble, and therefore they could be studied in details using different experimental and theoretical approaches. So, important question arises: what is the nature of intermediate species of this ruthenium 4 silicon polyoxymetallate in the water oxidation process? And to answer this question, we performed this investigation, this theoretical investigation. So here are its computational details. We investigated five species, five derivatives of the original compound. In the first compound, with charge 10 minus, all four ruthenium have oxidation state 4. In the second species, as we can see, one ruthenium has oxidation state 5, three still have oxidation state 4. In the third compound, two have oxidation state 5 and two have oxidation state 4. In the fourth compound, only one ruthenium still has oxidation state 4. And in the fifth compound, all four ruthenium are in oxidation state 5. So, and as we can see, charges of these compounds decrease from 10 minus to 6 minus. In our calculations, we used TurboMol 5.10 version software. Also, we used in the studies we used BP86 density functional in conjunction with the double zeta basis set implemented in TurboMol, which is called DFSVP or double zeta in other words. Calculations were carried out at the so-called resolution of identity or RIDFT level. The parallel RIDFT methodology implemented in TurboMol uses so-called auxiliary fitting basis sets, and it helps to avoid treating the complete set of two electron repulsion integrals in calculations, and therefore calculations are sped up significantly. So this table shows different spin states which were calculated for all five complexes. As we can see, for the original complex, complex one, the ground state is singlet. For complex two, we have the ground state doublet. Then for complex three, triplet. For complex four, quartet. And for complex five, quintet, correspondingly. These results did not change significantly when we use extended basis set, so-called triple zeta or def TZVP basis set implemented in TurboMol. So after we have studied all possible spin states of all the five compounds investigated in this research, we studied geometries and physicochemical properties of ground states using this extended approach, and also both in gas phase and with solvent effects from water taken into account using this model, so-called conductor-like screening model. So this is the calculated structure of the original compound, complex one. As we can see, four ruthenium and four water molecules coordinated to them. We can also clearly see oxobridges here and hydroxobridges as well. And here are five homo orbitals and five luma orbitals of the species one of the original complex calculated in the gas phase using this RIBP86 triple zeta approach.